I did my ACL during our semi-final for our Vic Res 2s. I was driving down the court and Bryce put the ball up from the transverse line and I went to hit circle edge, landed on one leg and my knee sort of buckled and just gave way. I ended up on the floor in the goal circle.
And then we've seen one of those injuries that none of us like seeing on a landing.
He's in incredible pain. I think it was his right knee.
How I felt was devastated because I've done my previous knee before, my left knee, quite a few years ago, and I sort of knew exactly when I'd done it what that meant.
An ACL injury is one of the most prevalent injuries in the knee for netballers. ACL stands for anterior cruciate ligament. That is one of the main ligaments that controls translation of the tibia on the femur or the femur on the tibia, which is basically the main thigh bone on the shin. So if you've had an ACL injury, what the treatment involves is generally, first up, if you've had a full grade 3 tear, you will require surgery. So there's no easy way around this kind of injury, it's very serious. And it generally requires the use of either a patella or a hamstring graft. So basically one of the grafts, they take part of your tendon from in front of your knee or behind your knee and actually insert that inside the knee joint. After that, once the surgery has gone well, you then have to do an intense period of rehabilitation.
So the road to recovery has been really long and very repetitive. The rehab is sort of the same thing every day for weeks on end, and you have to just continually chip away at sort of the exercises that you're doing, and it just takes a long time to get back to sort of feeling like your knee is normal again. So I think it's really important doing lots of strength and conditioning work around building up muscle to sort of support the knee. I've been doing this through seeing a strength and conditioning coach, which has been really valuable this time around. It's not something that I had the first time I did my knee. And I think that that's really helped with my confidence a lot.
And then obviously, once you've gone through the rehab, probably the hardest part of it mentally is actually getting back on the court and feeling comfortable. I know there's a lot of anxiety involved in the sport. It's a really difficult sport. There are a lot of injuries in our sport, and actually having the ability to trust your knee completely after it's had such an injury, that can be really hard. A lot of people are often hesitant in trusting themselves to be able to complete the movements at full speed or full pivoting, which can be one of the biggest parts of it mentally, really getting back to 100%.
So playing again feels good. It's been very nerve-wracking in the lead up to playing again. I guess just continually thinking, is my knee going to be okay? Is it going to hold up? But so far it's all been good, and it's been it's felt really strong while I've been playing. So the advice I would give someone who has just done their ACL would be to really push through with the rehab. It's really tedious and it's really time consuming, but if you do it properly and you follow what the physio says and what your surgeon says, in the long run it's going to be a lot better. And I certainly found that this time around. I wasn't very strict with my rehab the first time, and I've had quite a few issues with my knee since. So really, if you've done your knee, it's really important to take the time to do that rehab properly. I know I'd go back to you. Overthinking every word, and I hate it 'cause it's numb.